Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and iOS 17 has been looking great according to the rumors and leaks. But are they accurate? Over the past few weeks and months, a few leakers online have been claiming different changes coming to iOS 17. Some of the leaks have had a consensus across different leakers, including Mark Gurman, while some of them just haven't. However, a Twitter account who was leaking a lot of information the other day suddenly deleted their account after Apple announced Final Cut Pro and Logic Pro for iPad. They went on to Mac Rumors, stating that there was an internal Apple operation to catch the leaker, and ultimately, their sister, who they were getting the information from, was fired. This seems very unlikely, and even Mark Gurman stated that it's pretty much nonsense, saying that it's mind-boggling that anyone would believe this. So, whether or not any of that information was accurate, it seems to be based on what Mark Gurman has said as well, but the leaker had originally claimed that Final Cut Pro would release next year and then Logic Pro would come after that. Then Apple actually announced it and they deleted their account after that since they weren't accurate. They also had said iOS 16.5 would release after WWDC, but we know that it's actually coming this week. So let's break down what's actually accurate as far as the features that we believe to be accurate, since they're from reliable sources, and go over some of the more questionable ones out there so far. So the first thing we can pretty much guarantee is it looks like Apple's going to redesign the control center. Typically, we hear this just about every year, but there'll be things with refinements in here. Maybe not a full redesign, but some leakers have claimed that things like the flashlight, instead of having a stepped version of brightness, would instead just have a variable slider instead of just five different steps. Also, there'll be more use of the dynamic island. This seems likely in that Apple's really adopted this. It's expected to come to iPhone 15, and right now it's basically used for things such as timers or the stopwatch or different things with Apple Music and just not having a whole lot of uses. It's a great idea, but it seems underutilized, so having more features there makes sense. One thing that many of us are looking forward to that you can pretty much guarantee is this will be a stability and reliability update. That's according to Mark Gurman, and every leaker so far has said that. Originally, we thought there wouldn't hardly be any features in it, and it would focus on stability and reliability. That's great, as iOS 16 has been not so great up until more recently with the latest updates. We're also expecting performance enhancements, whether that's to older phones or whether or not even older phones are supported with the iPhone X and older. We don't really know, but it seems like all of the different phones will have support and then we'll have performance improvements in general. That's great news, as there's been odd lag here and there with things from the dynamic island to just different applications, opening, closing, swiping, things like that. That should be much better this time around. With the rise in AI, we're expecting Apple to at least integrate something into their services, whether that's search or something else completely, we don't know, but every year they typically update Spotlight with some sort of functionality. You can do things such as math here. You could maybe do 6 + 4. And it will actually give you the sum. So that's something that you'll see within Spotlight Search, probably getting enhanced to have more functionality than it does now. It's a super useful tool and makes sense that Apple would just add at least a few things, even if it's not incorporating AI. We're also expecting updates to Apple CarPlay. This was promised last year with iOS 16 and now seems to be finally rolling out in different vehicles that have been shown off, such as the Lincoln Nautilus for 2024. So it looks like it's sort of based on an Apple CarPlay setup where the whole dashboard, including gauges and more, would be taken over by it. So we're going to see more of that in the future. We're also expecting updates to the Apple Wallet. Apple Wallet is expected to get some sort of redesign, at least a little bit, and that's probably due to the additional features that keep being added to it. So if we go into the wallet, and we could see more and more different state IDs or driver's licenses, as we only have 3 currently, but as Apple adds more features, such as the Apple Savings account or Apple Pay Later, a different interface would be welcome to maybe unclutter it a little bit. Also, we're expecting Find My updates. Now, specifically what they're for, we're not exactly sure, but Find My in general could be cleaned up a little bit, and also Apple's been working on making sure that AirTags that are nearby that are not owned by you notify you that they're nearby. This has been a big problem, and even Apple and Google have paired together to make sure that there's some sort of notification system in place and standard that if there's some sort of tracker nearby, you're notified about it. So that makes sense that they would build something like that into Find My, or possibly even more features in there as well. We're also hearing that there's going to be a journaling app included. Now, a journaling app such as Day One, but built by Apple, and maybe using the device's information to actually put information in there. Now, Apple is typically pretty good at making their own apps, but other third-party app developers who are focused on it, such as Day One, will give you more features. For example, that's why I use Craft currently as far as notes go. It just seems to be more feature-packed, it looks better, and is more organized for me. But there are things such as the Notes app that works well. I would expect something like Day One, but maybe less feature-rich. But that's what we know is actually coming to iOS 17. It doesn't seem like that big of an update when you look at it that way. However, there's even more, as Apple's already shown off a few features that we haven't seen yet. One of them is iMessage contact key verification. We thought this was becoming already with iOS 16.4, where you would have contacts verified within iMessage and not really have any issues as far as knowing whether or not that's a legitimate text. One thing we know Apple's working on is accessibility modes with customization. Around the time of iOS 16.2, we thought Apple would introduce this based on some information that 9to5Mac had found in the code. They posted it on their site, and you can see what it would sort of look like with different customization, accessibility modes, and also different icons you could change for the home screen, making them larger if that was needed. This is something we haven't seen yet, and hopefully will be in iOS 17, as this would be great functionality added for accessibility. However, there's some questionable changes as well. Most of those seemed like they could be legitimate, but now that the leaker has disappeared, maybe they aren't. But other sources have sort of corroborated some of this information, so let's take a look at those. And some of those have to do with widgets. Widgets in particular are something that we've really used for a couple years, but haven't had a ton of functionality. We could have customizable widgets that actually allow for interactivity, meaning that we could maybe have a music widget where we could just change different songs or just get more functionality out of it in general. That's something that is still said to be in the works, but hasn't been confirmed by multiple sources. Also, we're hearing more and more about the lock screen being customizable. Now, that makes a little bit of sense since we can already do that, and maybe instead of just having what we currently have, some people have said we'd have more font customization, as well as more widgets or more information we could see on the screen. Then ultimately, we could share that through a share sheet, just like we can with the Apple Watch and custom setups. So something like that makes sense, but currently you can't really customize it to the point where sharing this out would make sense. So maybe we'll have some significant changes. As far as wallpapers, I definitely would like to see some changes. Recently, the Pride wallpaper was added and interacts like previous wallpapers, meaning that as you slide up and down, it moves, it has interactivity, and also when you switch from light to dark mode or back from dark mode to light mode, it actually changes. We've lost these wallpapers that have that ability, and it's definitely something I would like to see Apple bring back to all wallpapers in the future. So that's something we definitely could see fairly soon. Also, we can expect more live activities, whether that's current apps that we have. Recent rumors say that we could see maybe a larger map on the lock screen when we have directions for navigation enabled, or we could just see more interactivity with it in general. That makes a lot of sense, and also one of those things supposedly has to do with music. Music is said to get a full redesign this time around to get rid of some of the text that we currently have. It's fairly text heavy, and it would be more visual if it gets a redesign. I've never really liked it since they redesigned it to this sort of app. Hopefully they change it in the future, and I would really welcome some sort of change there. Current features allow for things such as lyrics, and that's said to be coming to the lock screen as well. So maybe we'll have the lyrics on the lock screen. Whether that's on the always on display is hard to say, but some of these features make sense as little additions to what we currently have. Again, we don't know that for sure though. These things could or could not be on iOS 17. Also, leaks from elsewhere have said that the app library will be getting an update. Currently, it's a really nice way just to sort of see all of your different apps in one place, but its organization is completely hands-off. You can't change anything about it. It would be nice to be able to organize these into categories that I would want to use regularly, putting not just what I have recently added at the top, but what I want at the top, maybe being able to fully rearrange this. Some of that customization makes sense, but a lot of things I don't think we'll see that have been leaked. However, I do expect at least a few of them to be accurate. Mark Gurman had recently said that he plans to actually release more in the future based off of his Mac Rumors podcast. So in a recent podcast with Mac Rumors, he said, some of the different features that he expects, and then that he'll have more in the coming weeks. So within the next couple of weeks, we could hear more and more as we get closer to the final release of iOS 17. Now, the good thing about all of these leaks sort of maybe not being true is that it opens the possibility of some surprises or maybe some disappointment. Apple hasn't seemed to surprise us for quite some time, and so hopefully we'll get some of that. We are expecting Apple to unveil an AR/VR headset at WWDC, and of course that code should be within iOS and iPadOS as well. So those are things I would really expect to be in the update, but some of the things such as interactive widgets I would love to see, but it's not really guaranteed. Also, one thing that could be in the update has to do with sideloading of apps. Now, the reason I didn't mention this earlier is while it seems likely, it doesn't seem likely across the world. It only seems like it's going to be in the European Union to comply with different rules in place. So it would allow for sideloading of apps, possibly additional app stores, and it's similar to the rule that's going to make Apple switch to USB-C on the iPhone with iPhone 15. So those things seem likely. Hopefully they'll expand that to the world. We can currently install apps on the Mac outside of the App Store. It would be a similar sort of setup. You don't have to do it, but you would have the option. Now, as far as iPadOS 17, we're not really hearing a whole lot about that. Now, recently, like I said, we had Final Cut Pro and Logic Pro announced, and that could mean we could get more functionality through the Thunderbolt port. Recent leaks have actually said that there would be some functionality here with different monitors, maybe different audio or video devices, and multiple hard drives or solid state drives for editing or something like that. I would love to see Apple redesign the Files app to make it more like the Mac. In fact, I would like this to be similar to a Mac when you plug it into a monitor. There's also rumors that maybe you could have a closed clamshell type of mode when you plug it into a monitor, meaning you could turn off the display and just use a mouse and keyboard with it like you can on a Mac. But again, a lot of those rumors and leaks were from that source that disappeared. Now, as far as anything else, well, watchOS 10 is also said to be one of the focuses to get a major redesign. So there could be a full redesign here with a focus on widgets and different interactivity that would be specific to the watch instead of sort of copying what we've had with the iPhone. We don't really know much more than that, but it seems that's going to get the big update along with that AR/VR headset. As far as features I would like to see, well, I think most people would like to see split view multitasking, where you could have an app at the top and the bottom, maybe iMessage on the top while you're watching a video on the bottom, or maybe just notes on the top while you're going through Safari and trying to take notes. Something like that would be welcome, but Apple hasn't done that yet. I think they should, as we have it on iPad, but other than that, there's not much more I want from iOS. It's at a point of maturity. Personally, I would just like to see a redesign of some of the icons, as they're a bit stale, and I personally am not a fan of flat design. A redesign of the music app, a redesign of icons, and some of the things I mentioned would be more than enough to make me happy with iOS 17, specifically stability. But let me know what you want most in the comments below. Hopefully we'll hear a little bit more, and of course on June 5th, we'll actually see everything from Apple, where we should have iOS 17 Beta 1 released to developers, then the public beta is usually a week or two after that. A final release is typically within a few months, in September, before the iPhone 15 launches. That's what Apple usually does every year, so it's not far away now, only a few weeks, and we'll see what iOS 17 really has to offer. So again, let me know what you're looking most forward to in the comments below, and of course, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe, and if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.